myself Punidastana, and I am going to teach first chapter, relation and function. The relation is a very common word, all of you heard every day around us. So many relations are there, just like a father, mother, friend. So what do you think about this relation? Here, suppose the relation is a father or is a friend. So the friend is, it is the linkage between the two person, or you can say the bond between the two person. This bond is known as a relation. When the two person are related with each other, means linkage with any bond, that bond is known as relation. But in mathematical term, this is different. Here, we'll define the relation R between the two person A and B. Here, this relation can be expressed in this form, in form of ordered pair, that is A and B. A is a pair of first component, this is a pair of second component. Now here, this A and B are two sets, any empty sets. Suppose it, this is 1 and 2, and set B is A and B. And this, we won't write down here, the Cartesian product between A and B. I think all of you know about the Cartesian product. Cartesian product means the product between the two sets. Just like here it is given A cross B, so it is 1A, 1B, 2A, and 2B. This is your all the possible ordered pair. And the relation is belongs to A cross B. Relation is A cross B. It means it will tell here any relation A cross B is written here. This is 2, 1, 2, 3, anything written here. Now, when we'll find out the subset of this one, R is the subset of A cross B. Subset means it is a member of, suppose A is belong to set A. It means that A is a member of set A. Member means, you know, this symbol is known as belongs. Belongs means is a member of. A is a member of set A. Similarly here, if R is any relation, suppose it is given that A cross B, so many sets are there, this 1, 2, 2, something is written here. So if R is indicate with 1, 2, 2, 1, because this is belongs to set A cross B. So A relation is, relation R is defined as, it is the subset of A cross B. Here it is, R is the subset of A cross B. Now, suppose, how to write the subsets of any set? Suppose any set is given 1 and 2. I think all of you know how to write the subsets. If subsets means, you know, every set is a subset of itself. It means all the elements which is given in this set is the member of subset. And each and every element of a given set is a subset of a set, given set. It means you can say this is 1, 2, 1, 2. These are the subsets. But one more is the subset. Every empty set you can express with letter 5, R this is. This R this. This empty set. This is also known as the subset of a given set. Means each and every element of a given set is the subset of given set. The set itself is a subset of given set. And empty set is also a subset of a given set. In the previous classes, all of you learned how to find out the number of subset of a set. So that is with letter formula, this is 2 to the power n. And express the number of elements present in a set. That is, here for example it is given 1 and 2 are only there. So 2 to the power 2 means 4 subsets are there. Similarly, in case of a relations, if any relation is defined from A to B, so we'll take a first component of a given relation always from set A and the second component always from set B, just like it is written here. Now, how to find out number of relation in a given set? So that number of relation expressed by an A cross B, by this formula you can find out the total relation in a given set. The slide here written. Not written here. So you learn this. The number of subsets, number of relations are an A cross B. You can say 2 to the power n A cross n B. Now in any relation, suppose any relation is given this. A, B belongs to A cross B, where A is belongs to set A and B is belongs to set B. This is any relation. Now in this relation, the first component, this is known as domain of that relation. Just written here, domain. The first component of a given relation always the domain of the relation. And the second component is the relation, that is the range of that relation. Now, the types of a relation. Now, the relation is especially defined. Just like any relation, that is, there is three types of a relation basically. First one is a reflexive relation. It's not given here. Reflexive relation means if A or A, if any relation, any component A related with A, here A is belongs to set A. That means this is your reflexive relation. Second one is your symmetric relation. If A and B related with each other by relation R, therefore B is also related with A by the same relation, then this type of relation is known as symmetric relation. Or you can say it is inverse relation also. Inverse, R this one. If relation is given AB, then R inverse is BA. This is your inverse relation. Is right minus 1, R dash also. Inverse relation. This is known as symmetric relation. If the relation between A and B, given that A is related by any relation B, therefore B is also related with A by the same relation, then it is known as symmetric relation. For example, suppose the two triangles are given here, two similar triangles are given. If a triangle A is similar to triangle B, this is given here, relation is similar, A is similar to B. So as you know, similar triangles here, what are similar triangles? The triangles which are equal are in all the, you can say that is a, the similar triangles are both triangles which are same in all respect. It means A is similar to B. Similar symbol is you. This is you know already. The three sides like this. Or you can say this one. If A is similar to B, then you can say B is also similar to A. So this relation is your symmetric relation. Right? Now, or one more example take. Suppose a relation is less than. Suppose here two numbers I have taken here. 1 and 2. This is any 1 is related with 2 by the relation is less than. So if A is less than B, it means A is related to B, or you can say 1 is related to 2, but this not compulsory that 2 is related to 1, because 2 is not less than 1. It is never. So the relation is not a symmetric relation. So if the relation is belonging in both the side, it means A is related to B and B is also related with A by the same relation, then you can say the given relation is symmetric relation only. Now the third one is transitive relation. In this relation, if A is related to B, suppose here these three components are there, two, three persons are there, A, B, C. A is related with B by any relation. Suppose is a friend of, is a friend. So you can say A is a friend of B. And B is also related with C by the same relation. B is also friend of C. So C is automatically related with A by the same relation. Is a friend. So A is also a friend of C. So this type of relation is known as transitive relation. One more example to take. Suppose I'll take it three numbers. These are. Now the relation is given is more than or greater than. Is greater than. And the ordered pair form is 2-1. 2-2 and 3-2 and 3-3. Suppose this is given any relation R. Now from this, we'll find out the pair which belongs to this one. How to collect? First relation is just now I told, is greater than. It means first component is greater than second component. So the first one is followed this one. So this is 2-1. Any other followed here? This one also followed? 3-2. So the relation is greater than. But this relation is not belongs to transitive relation, not a reflexive relation, and not a transsymmetric. Well, because 2 is related by 1, is greater than, 2 is greater than 1. But 1 is not greater than 2. So it means this relation is not followed. R is greater than. Here in a reflexive relation, we'll compare the first component, means the first person, by itself. So in case of this, is greater than. 2 is not a greater than itself. So this relation is also not indicated, not applicable here. Transitive also not applicable, because 2 is greater than 1, but 1 is not greater than 2. This is symmetric one, it is not applicable. And here, it is given, therefore, the smallest reflexive relation is called the identity relation. Means, just you know the reflexive relation, what is reflexive relation? I told reflexive relation means, if any relation will compare by itself only, that is reflexive. Suppose, A is related to B by any relation, defined as a father. A is a father of B. So here we want to calculate A or A. This is A is the father of A. Not possible. So this is not a reflexive relation. Clear? Now in this one, take one more example to prove the given relation. The relation is, suppose it is given that is equal to. The relation is equal to. So what it means? The two components I have taken here. This is a relation. Now we want to prove the given relation is a reflexive relation. This is a transitive relation or this is a symmetric relation. So how to prove this? First you say, you know, first reflexive relation means A R A, where A belongs to set A. What it means? A is equal to itself. Is it true? Yes. A, any person always equal to itself. When we'll compare? So you can say the given relation is a reflexive relation. Now the second one is A R B, if it is equal to B R A. How it is? A is equal to B equals to given a relation here. So you can say A is equal to B or B is also equals to A. You can say this. So this is your symmetric relation. So what is equal to is your symmetric also. Now, the third one is transitive relation. So here we will take a three numbers. Suppose I take A, B and C. The relation is equal to. If A is equal to B and B is equal to C, therefore you can say A is equal to C. Therefore you can say the given relation is transitive relation. Relation is equal to is a transitive relation. Now, the relation is specified, thus like any relation is equal to, if this relation is a reflexive relation, this relation is symmetric, and the relation is transitive also. If the given relation belongs all these three relations, therefore you can say the given relation is equivalence relation. Okay? So you can say the equivalence relation means the relation which is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Then it is reflexive relation. So this much, this is the first exercise. You can practice it today, and thank you.